Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today I have prepared two multiple choice questions for you. And here's the first question. What is the crossover percentage between two genes which are 10 map units apart? Imagine that we have here one chromosome, here we have another homologous chromosome. And let's say here we have gene A, locus for the gene A, and one chromosome has dominant allele A, another recessive allele A. And somewhere here we have a locus for the gene B, and one chromosome has dominant allele B, another recessive allele B. And if crossing over would happen, say, somewhere here, we would receive new products after meiosis. So we had before one chromosome with genotype capital A, capital B. So first variant capital A, capital B. And second chromosome we had a genotype small a, small b. So small a, small b. If crossing over would happen, we are going to get new genotypes, which would be capital A and small b, and another would be small a and capital B. That gives us information that crossing over happened between these two loci. If distance would be great, then we may have a higher probability that crossing over would happen. For example, it can happen here, it can happen here, it can happen here, or it can happen here. So the greater distance, the more chances that crossing over would happen between two loci or positions of the genes on chromosomes. But now imagine that we move this gene P here. And what would happen? We would see that probability that crossing over would happen between gene B and gene A reduced. Substantially reduced if we compare with the first position. So the frequency of the crossing over also would be reduced. So basically the distance between genes would be directly proportional to frequency of the crossing over between two genes. And if we know that frequency of the crossing over between two genes is 10%, we can say that distance between two genes would be 10 map units. So as you see, this is answer B. And if we would say that frequency of the crossing over between two loci or two genes would be 40% or 50%, then we can say that we have here 40 map units. But if we would have 50, exactly 50% of crossing over, we also can say that probably these genes are on the different chromosomes, not homologous chromosomes, because they would show independent assortment. So we expect that if genes are on the same chromosome, that crossing over would be less than 50%. The closer to loci to each other, the less frequency would be. But sometimes you can find that, for example, distance between gene A and B even more than 50 map units. It can be, for example, 120 map units. How we can get this number? And we can get this number if, for example, we would make multiple point crossing over. Let's say that here we would have gene C and gene, say, D, and we can get, for example, here crossing over frequency as 20%, between C and D 15%, and D and B, let's say 25%. So on the overall, we got here 60% crossing over frequency. So we can say that between gene A and B, we would have 60 MAP units. But we got this number because we did multiple point analysis of the crossing over. So now I hope you would understand this better. If we can move to the next question. For the cross of the two parental genotypes as follows, what is the probability that an offspring would be of this genotype? We assume that all these genes are on the separate chromosomes. And as you see, we have here gene A, which in diploid organism represented by two alleles in parent 1. Let's say this is parent 1. This parent is homozygous dominant. Parent 2 also homozygous dominant for the same gene. And probability that the offspring also would be homozygous dominant for this gene would be 100%. So we expect that offspring also would be homozygous dominant with probability of 100% or 1. As for the next gene, parent 1 is homozygous dominant, parent 2 is homozygous recessive. What is the probability that the offspring would be heterozygous? Once again, parent 1 only can give dominant allele B, it doesn't matter which one. Parent 1 has only dominant allele, parent 2 only have recessive allele. So parent 1 would give dominant allele, and parent 2 also would give recessive allele. So basically that means that progeny would have 100% chances to be heterozygous for the gene B. As for the next gene, gene C, parent 1 is homozygous dominant, parent 2 is heterozygous. So parent 1 only can give dominant allele C, but parent 2 can give either dominant allele C or recessive allele C. And we are looking for the probability of the offspring to be heterozygous. So probability that the parent 2 would give dominant allele and recessive allele would be 1/2 and 1/2. So probability that progeny would be heterozygous would be 1/2. And as for the last gene T, parent 1 is heterozygous, parent 2 is heterozygous. What is the probability that progeny also would be heterozygous? So parent 1 heterozygous, parent 2 heterozygous, and if we cross these two genotypes, we can find probability of the same genotype in their progeny. So capital D here, small d here, small d here, and small d here. As you see, probability of having heterozygous genotype in the progeny would be 2 out of 4 or 1/2. So probability that the progeny also would be heterozygous would be 1/2 for this gene D. And now we have to multiply all these independent probabilities, and we would find that answer would be 1/4. And this is answer C. 1/4 is the probability that if we cross two parents of these genotypes, that their progeny would be of this particular genotype. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates, and see you in the next video. Goodbye.